Tuomas Saarela. I'm UX designer at Yousician. My talk will be joined with Noe. He is a scrum master in our engagement squad. How many here knows what is scrum? So quite many. Okay, that's good, because our original idea was to also talk about scrum, but then we realized that actually half an hour is impossible. You cannot really even scratch the surface, so we left that out. It's been almost 40 years since designers started to work in the software industry, but it seems that we still have lots of room for improvement. At least in Yousician, when I joined, it wasn't always like that. That design was easy to do in this very agile environment. So, and when I was requested to talk here, here's the request. So actually already in this request, there's something in Yousician's perspectives, there's something wrong. At Yousician, our team structure goes like this. So we have small teams. It means usually less than 7 people. They're efficient. So that means that all the day-to-day operations needed are present in one of the team members. So if you need some certain resource, be it design or data analyze, you have to have it in the team. And finally, empowered. So teams have clear goals, which are set for them. And then within those goals, the team can independently decide how they're going to work. If you want to learn more about Yousician working culture, visit company.yousician.com. And our team called Engagement Squad, when I joined, there was product owner, 3 app programmers, backend programmer, and me as a designer. Then in last October, we decided to give a try for really scrum by the book, and one of the things we found out during scrum retrospectives was that we don't have all the resources in the team. So for example, QA was a huge bottleneck. So what happened during the autumn, we hired a QA specialist and also data analyst for the team. So the team structure in the end was something like this. Noe could easily have a like 2-hour presentation of Scrum, but in short, in my opinion, one of the biggest benefits was the power of the retrospective. So almost all of the things I'm talking about today were found out, and we found the solution for them during the retrospectives. So that's something I really encourage every team to do. So how we typically work at or worked in the autumn in Engagement Squad. Usually there was some kind of feature request from the product owner. Maybe the idea came out with other managers or someone else outside of the team. Then that idea was handed over to me to work with the design. Sometimes research was also involved. Then that idea or feature got into backlog refinement, sprint planning, and actually it was only at this point when the rest of the team ever saw those ideas. So until that point, developers were totally unaware what's coming. They didn't have their say on the feature. So of course, you can imagine that brings problems. Then the feature got implemented, and Yousician way is also that we measure every experiment. So So any change in the app, we put it as a separate experiment, which will we then A/B test to like certain number of people. So we always see where are the changes taking the product, and for that having a dedicated data analyst in the team is huge benefit. So sometimes it wasn't always like this. Sometimes those feature requests, they skipped the whole UX designer research part, and they went straight into the sprint. So that also can cause a lot of problems. One of the problems was that design was often not ready in time. These are, by the way, straight quotes from the retrospectives we had. Then we were working in silos. People felt that that often the designs are presented only in the meeting when we already should start to take some action on them. So there was almost always some kind of need to tweak the decisions that had been already made. So that was time consuming and very inefficient. Then one of the feedback was that we were working too much in Slack and email and Jira comments, so verbal communication was wanted. Then there was this mysticism of design. The design process or the tools I was using were not transparent to the rest of the team. I was also not using the same ticketing system, so the UX and design tickets were never in the same backlog. So it was just very mystical to the rest of the team how the design actually gets happened. One of the solutions we decided to try is called staggered sprint. Probably if you know Scrum, then you know the idea. So you always do design upfront. So at least one sprint before you have the design ready, and then when that design gets into implementation, you start the design for the next sprint. First, this seems like a good idea, but very soon it happened that the designs were not again ready in time. It felt that the handoff point was always problematic, so I was still working mostly alone, only collaborating with the product owner, and in a way this also felt like a kind of mini waterfall approach. Anyone here approach of concept or book called Lean UX? Some of you are, yeah. So at this point in the autumn, I happened to read this book, really, really nice book. I'm not gonna go too much into detail, but it's basically a evolution of product design and team collaboration. It's based on the lean startup and agile software development thinking, and basically the main message of the book is that the first attempt we're gonna do is probably wrong. So the sooner and faster we get that out in the field, we will get feedback how we should revise that iteration. Some of the ideas the book suggests is called dual track agile. So the same process, but all the tasks that are related to finding out if we're building the right feature, will this work? How it did work? They all called product discovery, and then the rest of the tasks are product execution. And the idea there is that that the team is split into these two units, but it's not same time the staggered sprint. So in dual track agile, the discovery is continuous process. So for execution sprints are actually quite nice idea. You have these 2 week slots, but it doesn't work that well with design or research. So dual track agile offers an interesting way to make this learning process more transparent and available for the team. The feedback we got from Dotrack Agile was good. People who were validating the feature in the discovery track were also present in the execution track. Some feedback we got that it was a great initiative to put the discovery out there, but you have to always also like dedicate time and resources to keep that discovery track alive. Is that sound circulating only for me or you two? If there's anyone at Yousician who could help with the sound, I would appreciate that. One of the things the book suggests are called collaborative methods. So there are collaborative research and collaborative design. Next, we're going to talk a little bit about this. So in January, or actually in the end of December, we were entering first sprint of the year, and we really didn't know what to build. So the backlog was mostly empty. And this was the first time we really decided to give a try to put these new discovery methods we were having. So in end of December we hold a short design sprint, not the full week thing, but we cut it to 3 days, and basically we started from the research facts that. Advanced players don't consider Yousician as a way to play songs. Sorry about the messy slide. This was the only photograph I had from that workshop. But basically, instead of having that ready-made idea or feature, we start from the actual problem. Like, what is the problem? And we really dig to the data together as a whole team. And the result from this was totally different than before when the team was handed these ready ideas. So I will show the feedback later. But in our experience, that was really good experience. So the ownership. Thank you. Ownership was high. And then when we finally transitioned to the implementation, it went smoothest ever. We were also experimenting with collaborative research. In our case, that meant that we started doing user testing every week. So even we didn't know that we have something to test, we still scheduled users to come every week, and that was good because the whole team was in the comfort of if you are unsure about something, we are only like few days from the next test where we can actually validate if that hypothesis is right or wrong. Also, what we started to do is before I was doing all the research alone, and then I did maybe 5 or 6 tests and then presented the research results to everyone. What we started to do was to, instead of me being alone with the user in the room, I started to bring always someone from the team as a note taker. So they were taking notes, and very often also they got some question in mind I didn't figure out to ask. And then the rest of the team was watching the test via stream. Maybe always everyone wasn't able to watch, but usually immediately after the test, preferably on the same day, we had a debriefing session. So instead of waiting that whole week and then like presenting the results of the research, because there was this note taker in the room who had their notes, and then a couple of other team members had already like taken notes. So immediately after the session, we had this debriefing where we went through the findings, And it turned out that there was so much findings myself alone, like couldn't always find. So it not only brought us more findings, but also the feedback from the team was that they started to understand who our users are, and they started to have more empathy also towards the users. Here's some feedback of the method. So our team really thought that they are not anymore feeded with ready-made ideas, but they can actually take part in the whole process. So the synergy we got from this we couldn't even imagined. Quickly, I mentioned about the handoff tool. So we were also experimenting first time using Invision Inspect as our handoff tool. So instead of handing over screenshots and text, I was creating this Inspect with Invision. So there that the developer can actually see all the specs of the assets and elements on the screen, and it. If you haven't ever tried out Invision Inspector, then also in Marvel they have their Inspect element. I really suggest trying that. So the updated workflow in the end was pretty much similar, but we had that discovery part always going on, and instead of feeding the team those features, we started to work from the user problem or outcome from the start. Something also that came during the retrospectives was digital prototyping. We haven't really got results from that yet, but one feedback we got from the developers was that making these experiments is always such a huge thing. You have to take into account so much of the existing code base, and you already have to think about how it's gonna get brought to others and refactoring and everything. So developers thought that this kind of way of that you can prototype without thinking making clean code, that's very valuable. So the updated workflow, basically the idea was to bring team in early, introduce problems, not features, have a constant user testing going on, and then having that discovery track always going on, and all the discovery tasks in the same team backlog. And in the end, we think that the mentality in the team got different, and all the team members like thought that they can have better impact what we're building. This is the last quote. So after trying out that these collaborative methods, the first sprint in January. This was the feedback from one of the team members. So, yeah, it was a successful experiment. Any questions?